Hey, guys, squirrels, everything in between. What are we doing today? A quick setup of a Epiphone SG guitar. First on the agenda, how bent is the neck today? Today's bent neck is brought to you by, it says the neck is probably okay. We are saying we are getting some fret buzzing. Let's just see what the hell is going on, folks. How's everybody doing? The weather, we're not sure. Yeah, we don't like that kind. Let's see what the string action says. Hold on. You know, that's the deal with a lot of these, is the frets are all wiggly and wobbly, and next we'll be looking for high frets. You know what I'm saying? Well, there's your problem, folks. String action set way too low on the bass side, and too high on the treble side. Now something bad has happened to my little ruler, because it appears that shite has gotten into the little graduations. There, that's better. Yeah, so let's just fix the string height and then we'll see if the buzzing goes away. Yes, I've demonstrated this trick before. You know. No, stop bar's fine. Just gotta lower the strings a bit on that side and raise them on that side. Okay, so the magic number I'm looking for here is 5/64. No, I think I damaged my ruler. This is not good at all. Well, there is another side, but it's backwards. That appears to be it. Maybe a tiny hair more. Tiny. And we'll retune. Yeah, this is really sad if I've screwed up this little ruler. Try cleaning it with something other than spit in a minute. What do you think? Yeah, so once again, big shout out to everybody for all the support. Keeps me going. Gives me the ability to keep screwing around on YouTube. Thanks to everybody who sent, donations for a sticker. If you didn't get your sticker, just double check. That you double check that you sent me your address, because sometimes there's a glitch in the universe there. That should be able to go lower. It should be able to go lower. We'll see. It's all about the Epiphone fretwork. But I gotta clean this ruler. It's like all the little things are full of poop. Now we're rocking. I must have had some goo on my hands or something. So, 5 and 3/64 would be a rocking setup. Let's tune her up to bitch and see what goes on. Yeah. Fail. See, almost. Always. So, we're just going to have to raise it up a little scooch, or we're going to get into fret leveling. What can I tell you?
Yeah, I can't tell a lie. One high fret spoils the whole bunch. Okay, so, quick, easy up phone setup. Ain't going to happen. Unless you want to be like the guys at Guitar Center and they would do exactly what I just said. We'll just raise it up a little bit and make that go away, even though it's not right. That's what usually you get. Okay, this isn't too bad. It's just one, and it really is, if we're very critical, it's just on the treble side. Yeah, it's fine there. Then it starts to go bad there, and there, and then there. All right. Once again, the good old dime store rubber eraser comes to the rescue, and I am just going to use the cutting file here. We just take that down enough. You know what I'm saying there, guys? Kind of need to get a little more. There we go. Close, really isn't much, and especially that high up on the neck. You can get away with a couple lumpy frets lower on the fretboard, but this will never save you. And yeah, you get the idea. Running into danger here though with the edge of the guitar. Maybe I'm just going to get a different file. It gets me out of the way. That's the ticket. That's the ticket. Yeah, we got that. Sure. Okay, let's just polish that up a little bit, and I kind of wish the owner hadn't put new strings on it, because then I would have oiled the fretboard. It sort of needs that, and she looks a little dry, but... Well, you know what, Dave? If there is a solution to that, let me just do that.
Yeah, there's this old trick. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to loosen the strings right off. And I'm going to just release the whole stop bar. And all the strings will pop right off. We can do it, folks. Then I can put some oil on that fretboard. And it'll be easier. Look, the string got me. Oh, no! Look at it. It blew up. There, we'll do it like that. Oh no, I think my tube is dead. That's the problem. Goodness, we're in trouble. Okay, not to make a mess of the hardware. Some have proposed using a coin. I tried every Canadian coin I own, and they don't fit in there. See, look, you get all the strings. They don't all come off the tuning heads, and you don't have to wrestle with all that, because we don't like that kind. What was I going to do? Polish that fret and put a little love on this fretboard. Well, oh no, it's the buzzer alarm. That bullshit's gone. The other one's gone at the other end. Oh, intonation for the nation.
Yes, ma'am. Your E string is sharp.
Actually, no, I think it's flat.
No, it's sharp. It means it's too short, which means we have to loosen the lower something. We gotta do something. First, we gotta loosen the string.
Then, we gotta get it out of the way. And then, we gotta move this guy back a tiny amount. And we're gonna do that.
Okay.
G is sharp as well.
Oh, and just to make everybody happy, I'm going to do this. Why? See, I got the rowboat there for the maximum neck support. Because everybody's all worried.
This throws the intonation off of a guitar. Pete Townsend would have had a problem.
Okay?
It's just like playing position, laying down, I don't know, swinging your arm like a windmill, jumping around like a jackass. It's like, yeah. My intonation.
That is sharp.
Okay then. Pick a pipe. Let's do it. Okay, we don't need to listen to it. Right? We don't need to listen to the pick a pipe. And this is about an eighth of an inch. And that one's too close. Where did that other guy go? There you are. Down a little bit. That's nice. Back one's good. Then we're going to go for 332s on the treble side. And that one, once again, is a little too close. Right? Right. Okay, so we're just about out of this. Thanking everybody once again for tuning in and supporting the channel, because that's what it's all about. It's not supporting me, guys. It's supporting the channel. Oh, this thing, shut it! Did you already... There's my text. Did you already piss him off? See? People know me, right? It's just like... They just know that I'm such an unbelievably nice guy to a point. And then something in my head snaps and you're off my list. That's not to say you couldn't end up back on the list, but, you know, it's like, what was that one? The meme. It's just like, yeah, I'm not the fuckface whisperer. Well, that looks pretty swanky squanky, guys. I think we'll just let it sit for a while and check it all again. I'm going to just check that neck relief one more time. Because, just to make sure it's okay before I put it down. And then we'll look at it again after I put it down. And that's the 17th fret. This is a 12th thou feeler gauge. And capo on the first fret, looking at 7th fret. And this needs to just sliver in there. You just, that's what they call it, a feeler gauge. You can just feel it touching. You know? Just feel it. Feel it with all of your feelings. All right, folks, I quit this guy. Epiphone SG, quick setup, one high fret, string action too low, pickup height close, intonation. Oh, would you shut it? I gotta stop making movies with my phone on. I apologize, folks. I'm gonna kill this thing now. Anyway, I will deal with the phone. Thank you to everybody. This guy will enjoy his guitar now because it plays right. Imagine that. Cheers.